terrible news. Breaking news coming out of New Zealand this morning. Multiple people have been killed after a fire broke out in a hostel in Wellington.
It's understood up to 90 people were staying in the building at the time of the fire. So far, 52 have been accounted for.
The city's mayor spoke to media just a short time ago.
When I got down here, we then discovered from our fire emergency team that there have been multiple fatalities, the final number yet to be determined. So it is a truly tragic situation, the worst outcome. But our fire emergency department have done a really wonderful job at managing this. They no doubt will be going through a very tough time, and of course our families of the fatalities will be going through a tough time as well.
It is a terrible scene there this morning. We're just getting more details as we go to air right now. There are some 90 people inside at the time, and only around 60 have been accounted for. So there's grave concern for the others. There are also eyewitness accounts coming out of there saying that everyone living there, they have nurses, doctors, unemployed people, meat workers, hospital staff. This is an eyewitness as I'm talking to you at home. All sorts of people, a real variety of people, says one witness. The witness says it's very sad for a lot of people, not only the ones who have lost their lives, but those who have lost their homes. It's surreal. It's a terrible feeling. Lots of emergency services are on the scene right now, and still firefighters haven't been able to go into some of those club rooms, they're calling them, to try and assess just how many people were inside at the time. Remarkable stories, remarkable rescues, as we were saying before, from the roof of that hostel. Clearly they couldn't go down to get out of that place, so they went to the roof, and some have been able to get out off the roof, but as you can see there, the fire just tore through this building.
At least a dozen expected to be confirmed dead, but we still don't know how many more are unaccounted for. As well, some of the emergency workers were on the phone with the occupants, and that call then cut out, so the fate of those people is still unknown. So there is still a lot to sort of work out, and this scene is just awful.
Well, there's a number of other associated issues, not just around the vicinity of the building, but it's an old building, so there are asbestos issues. So people in the Wellington area are being urged to stay away from the area, but wear masks as well. So you can see all the emergency services there have these masks on. So asbestos is another problem being loaded on to what is a significant emergency situation as we go to air this morning in Wellington. Unfortunately, it does not look good there this morning. And we'll be there live with more reports from the scene as soon as we possibly can. This tragic breaking news out of New Zealand this morning. Six people are dead after a fire tore through a hostel in Wellington. The death toll expected to rise. 20 people have been injured. Their conditions at this stage unclear.
It's understood up to 90 people were staying in the building at the time of the fire. So far, 52 have been accounted for. Just moments ago, authorities gave an update on the situation.
I'm a little bit reluctant at this point in time to confirm numbers. However, my understanding is that it is less than 10 at this point.
We have had reports that the roof was possibly asbestos, but that's unconfirmed at this stage. We're actually just deploying an urban search and rescue crew who's going to come in and work with our police colleagues working through the building. And we've, as you'll see across the road, we've got crews on standby who are there for other duties if required.
So this is what we know. The fire broke out at Loafers Lodge, which is in the southern part of Wellington, just after midnight. Prime Minister Chris Hipkins spoke to New Zealand Television.
It's an absolute tragedy, and you know, Wellington, as you know, Ryan, is a small, close-knit community, and I think Wellingtonians will certainly be feeling this morning. Can I just acknowledge the incredible effort of our firefighters in the early hours of the morning to get people out of the building, to try and get the fire out, putting themselves in harm's way to do that. Can I acknowledge the victims and their families?
Have you been told how many fatalities, Prime Minister?
I've had varying reports. I understand six confirmed previously, but it looks like there are likely to be more.
This is what's left of the building this morning. Large parts of the outside of the hostel completely scorched.
TVNZ reporter Jessica Swan joins us now from Wellington. Jess, good morning to you. I mean, it's just the most awful of mornings for everyone in Wellington, across New Zealand. What is the latest you can give us?
Sophia. Good morning to you. As you say, we've just got some of those numbers that we've been waiting for all morning. So we know that there's at least 6 fatalities, and police are saying it's probably under 10. We also know there's approximately 30 people still unaccounted for. In terms of injuries, Wellington Free Ambulance treated 15 people at the scene. There are now 5 in hospital. One of those is in a serious condition. Now, the fire occurred to the building to my right. It's a hostel, as you say, that could sleep around 90 people, and we've got 52 accounted for, so some gaps there in the numbers. Now, 5 people had to be rescued from the rooftop. It was a big rescue operation, and I spoke to one of those residents who had to flee. He described big black smoke, people yelling for help. He said it appeared that there was 2 fires, and it was that second fire that was the larger one that caused people having to leave. Now, we spoke to an emotional local Wellington mayor, Tori Farno, this morning, but she said that a mayoral relief fund has already been set up, so they've been speaking with our finance minister, Grant Robertson, and that money will go towards supporting both the families' victims, so those who passed away, but also those who have had to be displaced. Now, this all began just after midnight at around 12:30 a.m. and the fire crews, who were actually quite close to this location, immediately elevated the situation to a 5th alarm. By 4 a.m. there were 20 appliances here. Now, the roads are beginning to open again. Things are getting a little bit back to normal, but emergency services are expected to be here throughout today to determine what the cause was.
And that's the thing, isn't it? We still don't know what the cause was, but we are hearing reports that the blaze may have been deliberately lit. Is there anything further on that?
Yeah, well, when I spoke to this resident in particular, he mentioned that there might have been some damage done deliberately. He said that some people who had recently moved into the temporary accommodation had caused damage. However, we haven't heard from authorities whether that would be the case. And as I say, it appears there were the 2 fires. Again, this resident mentioned that the first one appeared to be a sort of burnt toast incident, something, an accident in the kitchen. It's whether that second one might have been deliberate. That's probably in question at this point.
Just such a difficult building to access, and this fire, it went really quickly into a lot of different parts of the building, and we're trying to establish now, and authorities are, that massive gap between 52 or so who are accounted for and the 90 who may have been in there at the time. That's a huge gap. We understand that maybe because shift workers may not have been there at the time. Can you just explain that to us and when authorities might get a handle on just how many may have been inside?
Well, the nature of this accommodation is it's temporary, so short and long-term stays, and that means, as police described, it's quite a transient location. So the first big issue there is actually determining how many people there should have been there. Like you say, a lot of people there also work shift work, so it's working out how many people were staying there and then how many of those were actually on site. Now, we did speak to police a short time ago, but I don't think we're going to receive an update for quite some time yet around those figures. They are urging anybody in this area or who is staying there or has family to reach out so that they can determine how many people they're actually dealing with in those non-accounted for numbers.
All right, it's a very busy morning and tragic morning. We appreciate all the details you've given us, Jess. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks, Jess.
Awful situation there in Wellington. We'll